firm of aviation. There were two brothers, Joseph and Anton Montgolfier. These two brothers were actually paper manufacturers for King Louis XVI, and everybody knows what country he would have been the king of, right? Interactive here. What country?
France.
All right, great. We're there. All right, well, they made paper parchments and scrolls for the king, and then one day outside their paper mill, they saw pieces of paper going up in the smoke. They thought it'd be great if they could find a way to use this smoke to fly. So they made a paper sack and they filled it with smoke and it flew. That's where they got the idea to make a Montgolfier. Of course, they were not going to make a balloon. Well, they didn't even know what a balloon was then. There was no such word. So in France, they called them Montgolfiers, named after the two brothers. They went to the king with their idea, and he thought it would be wonderful that France would be the very first country in the world to fly man in the air. And so he loaned them some money. They made a large balloon of silk. Actually, their large balloon was about a quarter of the size of the balloons that we were flying in today. But still, that means that balloon they made was about the size of a house. Ours is about the size of a 6 or 7 story building. Now, they had the balloon ready to go on November the 21st of 1783. They were going to fly it from the Palace of Versailles just outside of Paris. Now, Joseph and Anton wanted to go on board, but the king didn't like that idea. The king came up with the idea of go to the local Bastille, grab a prisoner, put him on board, and then if he lived, then I would give him a full pardon, he said. But if he didn't, then c'est la vie. But they thought this would be horrible for a prisoner. We have to have royalty or noblemen or something to be on the very first flight. So they went to the queen, Marie Antoinette, and convinced her to allow them to put royalty on board. So she went to the king and was able to change his mind, since the royalty came from his royal menagerie, a sheep, a duck, and a rooster. They put them in cages on this round wooden platform with a large hole in the middle of it. That's where they built their fire. Filled this balloon, this silk balloon, with paper on the inside of it, with smoke. Now today we still fly with paper, because if they had not have used that paper, that balloon probably never would have got off the ground, because it's the paper that holds the heat in. Just like today. Now, I knew my passenger saw the paper on the inside. Did you see it? Well, we have special balloon with special invisible paper on the inside. It's actually a silicone coating that's sprayed on the inside of the fabric, which helps the heat stay in. If it was just plain fabric, nylon fabric, we'd be burning the whole time and probably be able to fly about 15 minutes, about 5 feet off the ground. That would be it. So, thanks to that paper, we can fly for quite a while these days. Now, they put the animals on board. The balloon lifted off shortly after noon. They had it tied down with 3 ropes, and eventually they cut the ropes, and away it flew. They say the first flight lasted approximately 20 minutes. Flew away from the palace grounds, just like we did today. Now, their flight path was up with the wind and down with the wind. Went over the horizon line into the farmer's fields. They had no idea what was going on. So they look up and see this huge thing coming at them in the air. Well, of course, being 1783, there's not supposed to be anything in the air except birds. Well, this was definitely no bird. Like I say, about the size of a house, smoke coming out of it, making animal noises. So they knew exactly what had happened. They had their first fire-breathing dragon. Well, we all know what Frenchmen do to dragons. You slay them. Well, they rallied together, pitchforks, sickles in hands, tore the balloon to pieces when it came in. The animals lived, so it taught us that we'd be able to breathe once we left the earth. But they went back to the king and said, the flying is great, but the farmers revolted. What can we do? So the king thought for a moment. He sent a man down to his wine cellar, came back with a bottle of the king's wine that had his seal on it. So he said, the next time you go flying, carry this bottle of wine with you, and when you come in for a landing, hold it out and show the farmers that you're civilized. Well, of course, in France, that works very well if you have a bottle of wine. You can get away with almost anything. And with the bottle of the king's wine, you can get away with anything. Well, it was great. So they started carrying wine with them. That's why champagne and wine is tradition ballooning from that very first flight. Now, approximately around 100 years later or so, there was an Irish monk who was able to go along on a balloon flight once and thought it was so wonderful that he wanted to sanctify this act of flying balloons, or bless it, you might say. So he wrote a prayer for us balloonists, and I'll recite that to you now. The winds have welcomed you with softness, and the sun has blessed you with his warm hands. You have flown so high and so well that God has joined you in your laughter and has set you gently back again into the loving arms of Mother Earth. Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
May there be
Cheers.
Many more balloon flights in all of your lives. You are all officially about an hour and 15 minutes younger right now, and also licensed to have a nap every day. All right. Again, thanks, guys. Welcome. Now, again, birthdays, right? We've got a birthday here and another one over, was over here. Where did our birthday person go?
Down there, or did they leave?
I don't know.
I saw him taking pictures of the vineyard, but it's our birthday
too. Okay, your birthday. Okay, it's standing birthday man here.
Okay.
Because there's cake and candles. So, you know what that means. With candles, lit candles, what do you have to do?
Sing.
And? Ta-da! All right, the cake is over here. So anybody with cameras, bring your cameras up just in case they accidentally fall over with their face into the cake. You might want to have a camera ready. And you never know.